146 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee. On the left of your screen, Buddy Wayne. And at 232 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, the King, Jerry Lawler. One fall, 15-minute time limit match. Jerry Calhoun's the referee.
All righty, bell time, maybe. Here we go, if we can get it to ring. Everything else has been that way today.
Yes, sir.
Way, Buddy Wayne, going against the King, Jerry Lawler. And Buddy going at him with that right hand. Jerry blocks him, zings a big right back, comes right over on top of Buddy Wayne. Starts pounding away, and referee goes.
Oh, look out.
One.
Stop.
Well, if we end up with anything left here, Dave, it is a disqualification on this one. Hart, the first family.
Lawler, both of the heartbreakers.
Dream.
A dream machine. Dream with a club.
Did he hit
Lawler? He hit Lawler. He's all over Lawler in here.
The Braun, the Dream.
Here comes Keirn, Mantell, and Dundee.
Hey, come on, Jerry.
A dream machine.
Come on, Eddie, get to you. See if you can get some of those guys out of there.
All right, dream machine hit Lawler. Still trying to work on him. Dundee and Mantell shove him out of here.
Lawler really stomped upon.
I am not believing. The dream machine came out and nailed Lawler with a club or something like that.
Yeah. I thought he was going after Hart, but and he swung and he hit Lawler, and then he came back and really started working him over.
Trying to get Jerry McGraw joined by the dream machine. You heard it right. I couldn't believe what I was seeing in there. I thought maybe he missed him the first time and just accidentally hit him, but there wasn't anything accidental about that.
No doubt about it.
He just was pounding on him and then joined with McGraw dropping the big elbows on him. The whole first family doing it. Lawler being carried out of the area where the whole first family jumped on him. Oh. They jumped. McGraw, get those guys out of here. The floor, they're going after Hart underneath the ring. That's the King. They came back in and dumped him off that chair where they had they were carrying Lawler out on it. The dream machine is Hart. That's Bugsy McGraw. Initially brought in the dream machine. I am not believing. They come in here and jump him in the ring and then dump him off the spot. Get up. Jimmy, I don't even want to hear. What in the Sam Hill is this, Dream?
TCB. TCB taking care of business. Dream's not digging the coffin buying a long time. We've been understanding the crime because all the King's horses and all the King's men. Can't put the King back together again, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, well, cut all that garbage out of it. What the Sam Hill you mean?
Well, I'm
in.
Trying to tell you, if you'll shut up long enough before I can tell you, let me tell you something. Every time it come down the pike, every time something took place, title shots, championship matches, it's always Lawler and Dundee. Lawler and Dundee, but this man right here give me the greatest chance of all to be on top right off the bat. against Jerry Lawler. And you know one other thing? This right here bring it all down to a screeching halt, if you know what I'm talking about, baby. Because 10,000 people watching. Said, don't take your mask off, Dream. The only thing that I held with value, my mask. Say, don't take it off, baby. Don't take it off. And then who, out of all people now, so you tell the Dream Machine, who comes out and holds up a towel and says, oh, it's all right, Dream. Go ahead and take it off. Jerry Lawler, shame me one more time. But you know something. All the king's horses and all the king's men can't put the king back together again. Because I am that man that walked that barbed wire fence 32,000 miles barefooted. He still saw taste that lighting with bread. Picked up the blue gear. Big man, we are here to stay, brother, not to play. You know what I'm saying, but it's going to be that graveyard digging a coffin vine a long time we've been. And our family
to get serious, baby.
Yeah, that's it. Because we're family, all my brothers and sisters.
I'm telling you, Dream.
The number one
family. Get you. He'll get you for it's over with. Okay, get out of here. Let's take a break. Back ready for official action in the ring right now, Dave. It's, well, we're not exactly ready, but we're close to it. Yamamoto out here with Onita and Fuchi. And Roy Rogers, who was supposed to go. Yeah, Billy.
You ain't got no partner with Dream Machine. You just hang on to this, and he's about to have a partner, Daddy. He's about to have me, because I don't like him.
You got
a partner. Well, that's that wiry little Australian. Dundee's just got his blue jeans on. Dream Machine sure isn't going to be his fault. Okay, Dave, I guess do it the official way.
All right, it's going to be Mr. Onita Masa Fuchi from Japan, total of 450 pounds, against Roy Rogers from Nashville, Bill Dundee from Australia. Jerry Calhoun's the referee. It's expiration of time, and we are underway. Dundee in here against Onita. Backdrop, Onita on the mat. Dundee wrestling in his blue jeans. Last minute substitution for Roy Rogers' partner was to have been Dream Machine, but due to problems which developed earlier. Roy Rogers left without a partner, and Dundee stepped in there. He was itching to get at these Japanese anyway. In there now against Masa Fuchi. Got him down on the mat. Pounding him with a right hand. Superstar back onto the ropes, takes a chop from Fuchi, and another one. Masa Fuchi makes the tag. Mr. Onita. Tojo from outside has Dundee by the hair. Three trying to get Onita back. Dundee can get back in the ring. Oh, after a chop, Dundee with a forearm out of the corner put Fuchi on the mat. Tag made, and here's Roy Rogers. Rogers, body slam, Masa Fuchi takes a shot at Mr. Onita on the way. Rogers back on the ropes, and here's Dundee. Referee Jerry Calhoun hits the mat. Oh, chop you can hear downtown. Onita working on Bill Dundee. Referee Jerry Calhoun trying to get them separated. Tojo Yamamoto is involved in that, while Masa Fuchi is working on Roy Rogers. Dundee rolled off the apron, down onto the floor. Onita starts after him. Fuchi stopping Roy Rogers. Rogers trying to battle his way off the rope. Onita chops him back into the corner. Dundee through the ropes. heads for the action, sent back to the corner by the referee. Trying to fight his way out of it. Onita grabs him. Trying to keep him out of the corner and attack on partner Bill Dundee. 3.5 minutes gone in this first ball of action. Expiration of time match. Jab by the Japanese. Rogers gets the time. Here's Dundee. Fuchi both hit the mat. Shoulder butt by Dundee coming off the ropes, but Fuchi was set and both wrestlers down. Yeah, Tojo Yamamoto kind of sneaking around behind Bill Dundee. The referee telling him to sit down. Meanwhile, Mr. Onita steps in and chops Bill Dundee as he had just struggled to his feet. Masa Fuchi on his feet. He chops Bill. Over to the corner, the tag on Onita. Onita, middle rope. There's a cover. One, two. Two count, and Dundee breaks it at the count of two. 4 minutes, 45 seconds. We're very close to that 5 minute mark. First fall action. Tojo grabbing Dundee from outside. Fuchi grabbed Dundee, kept him away from the corner. Masa Fuchi with Dundee back under the rope. The superstar off the ropes and into a double-handed chop. Before the count starts, though, Dundee had broken the cover by Masa Fuchi. Onita takes the tag. Bill Dundee in the Japanese corner. 6 minutes gone. 6 minutes gone in the first fall. Mr. Onita. Whoa. Nailed and put down on the mat by Bill Dundee. Dundee going for a sleeper. Tojo jumps in there. That's going to be it. Disqualification on the Japanese team. Bill Dundee going for the sleeper hole. Looked like he had a pretty good one. I don't need it. His knee turns. Dutch Mantell. Keirn with a war club. Ooh. Oh, Fuchi's back and then Onita's. And Tojo, Fuchi, and Onita leave the area. Dundee and Roy Rogers going to be the winners of that first fall due to disqualification. Whoop, when Tojo jumped in there.
Boy, the natives are restless today. But right now, it's going to be time for us to get filled in at the individual request of the head of the first family.
What are we waiting for? What they've all been waiting for, baby. Yeah. Look, the first video.
An update, a report on the family.
Look at this right here, man. Star Magazine, Ladies Diana Family Secrets. They're trying to say I was with Lady Diana. I've never been with that broad in my life, man. I don't even know who she is.
I settled the baseball strike. Everything is going great for the First Family, man. I got my cast off. Look at this, Russell.
I know
great tonight. Big Bugsy McGraw, the Dream Machine, my nightmares. Hey, Danny, baby, looking beautiful. Chick, my super assistant right here. What do you want to ask us, brother?
I notice he's still on crutches.
Don't you worry. That's right, baby. We're on top of the world, baby. We're on top of the world, right, Bugsy,
well,
darling?
Right. We're well, we're rare, and we're there. Come and get us, baby.
Over here, come on, up top.
Look how pretty I am. Look how pretty I am.
Come on, now, Lawler. Don't start it. We've been...
Come on, get him out of here.
He's got the whip. He's got the whip now. No, no.
Come on. This gun. Eddie, get in here again. Hey, Lawler, don't do that. Oh, no. Come on, Jerry. Knock that stuff off now. Lawler, will you quit that stuff now? You're messing up the whole place. Come on, Jerry. Get out of here with that stuff. Get some of this stuff. Now, this is ridiculous. This is ridiculous, Eddie. Get him up. Come on. Oh, you're messing this thing up. Will you please get out of here? Hey, come on, you guys. I know. Fun, fun, fun. Ridiculous, Eddie.
Come on, he acts like this. He's going to be suspended.
You know, everybody's having fun. Okay. Tell you, these guys are absolutely getting crazy. Was kind of funny. Let's take a break. I'm going to be back in a minute. Ease out.
Right, the cleanup is continuing down on the floor here from the feathers. In the ring, you see the Japanese team, Mr. Onita, Masa, Fuchi, Tojo, Yamamoto in the foreground, their manager. They're challenging for the belts. This is a title match, and the champions with the belts have just stepped into the ring. It'll be a one-fall, 60-minute time limit match. One-fall, 60-minute time limit at 450 pounds, challenging for the titles from Nagasaki, Japan, Mr. Onita. His partner from Hiroshima, Masa Fuchi, their manager, Tojo Yamamoto. The champion at a total weight, 446 pounds, from Australia, the superstar, Bill Dundee. From Memphis, Tennessee, the King, Jerry Lawler. One fall, 60-minute time limit. And your referee is Jerry Calhoun for this championship match. See, let's get the belts.
Okay, Dave. And he plastered Hart down with that molasses and then dumped all of those feathers in. Okay, we're down to a title defense. Let's see if we can get back into action on it while the cleanup continues.
Dundee starts against Masa Fuchi. Feeling good.
Yeah, I went up there and I was trying to have a reasonable conversation with Lawler and Billy and all that.
Dundee says, well, he's a chicken anyhow. We figured we ought to put a little feathers on him. So. Okay, we're into action here. AWA Southern Tag Title. This is going to be a 60-minute beautiful reversal by Billy right there. He started to whip him across. Onita came over there to nail him to help break his ball, and Billy just wheeled him back around, dumped him into the same tongue turnbuckles he just left. Onita, Fuchi, Yamamoto at ringside, not happy with the way it's all starting out here. As Dundee and Lawler teaming well, as they always do. These guys just have a magic in this tag team. We look back over the years. Of course, Lawler and White were such a sensational tag team. Dundee and Barnes were a great team. None of them have ever been any better than Lawler and Dundee, though, together.
Well, you're right. One of the best ever. The Australian, Bill Dundee. He stepped out of the way. Whoa, he does it again, and Masa Fuchi nails Mr. Onita. Boy, can you imagine what's going through Tojo Yamamoto's mind right now?
I got a feeling his boys may find out here in just a moment. Look at him talking to Fuchi down here. Tojo hot.
Oh, Dundee coming after him.
Billy slid through and dropped the foot right behind Tojo's direction. But the Oriental Master slipped out of the way, and now he's telling the referee, keep him in control. Onita back up on the ring apron. Just realized, I guess, in talking about Lawler and Dundee, you have to because they're spectacular. But we are negligent if we're at all honest in not pointing out this Onita and Fuchi are just kind of taking together. They've adapted well to a catch as catch can style, and they are really tough.
Well, off to the crowd. How about a little fist? Crowd says yes, so he responded.
He applied.
Onita rolling back to the corner, tags Masa Fuchi. Miller greets him with the same right hand. That's the crowd. They say, yeah. There he goes.
He didn't want to show any partiality to Onita. So he gives it to Fuchi.
We're 3 minutes, 10 seconds into the action now.
The referee's giving it to Lawler. Telling him about the use of that fist. Tag out, Onita coming in. Center of the ring. He's setting up for his scorpion. This Onita has big legs. Oh, Billy! We were sitting there watching the referee and Lawler, and Bill came slipping in behind and really belted him one.
That could have some effect later on, too. Onita has to worry about all sides. He was setting up that concentration, it looked like. It was interrupted by Mr. Dundee.
I was getting ready to say how well he does perform with his feet. Onita is deadly with those feet. And Dundee interrupted that.
He's wrapping up that left arm. Stepped over near the corner. Onita from out on the apron.
Onita's got Fuchi's arm. He's out here passing it. Look at Tojo. He's poking Onita in the stomach. He's pumping him, and Tojo's about to chop him. Oh, Anita's saying, big mistake.
Hey, Coach, I think Tojo is giving him the Japanese equivalent of look before you leap.
That's it.
We are now 5 minutes, 18 seconds into the action.
Fuchi tagging out, and he is not particularly happy with the events that transpired in there. Okay, Onita in there with the King as we have rolled past the five-minute mark. And we're heading into the six-minute count. It is a one-fall 60 minutes. We do have standby matches. Dundee, once again, slips in behind. The referee telling him to get out of the ring. And Lawler lays the big right hand right on Onita. And Mr. Onita from Nagasaki tags out to Masa Fuchi.
Jerry Calhoun right there. He tried to get Fuchi back away from Lawler while he is in the corner. Chop across the top of the head. Whoa! Lawler fought his way out of there. Over to the corner and tag Bill Dundee. Dundee and Onita. Dundee popped him into the rope. Fuchi is able to get to it.
Tojo really extorting Fuchi and Onita down there. He wants those AWA titles. Fuchi, big job. Working on Billy. Chop right off the rope. He's going after him. One.
7 minutes, 45 seconds into the action.
There's a tag on Lawler. The King singing with that right hand. He throws the big cannon pretty well. You better believe that, legal or not. Whip over into the corner on Dundee's foot, a tag back to Billy. Fuchi into the rope. Dundee, there's that flying press. Get out of here, Hart. You got no business in here. Jimmy, get it. Come on, Jerry. Now, we've had all of this for one day, I want to see. Get him off of it. Calhoun, get him out of here. Machine, Bugsy McGraw, the Nightmares. Hart came out here. Sandbag Lawler out of the ring. Jumped all over, and Dundee up in the ring is being pinned by Onita. Count of one, two, three. Steve Curry, the Gibson, Dutch Mantell. Over here, Lawler, the Nightmares, Gibson. There go the Gibsons up into the ring. Lawler decked by the Nightmare and the Dream Machine coming after him. Steve Keirn battling with the other Nightmare while in the ring. Onita and the Gibsons going at it. Watch out, dude. Mantell and Bubsy down. Lawler down with the Dream back in the ring. Both Japanese wrestlers working on Robert Gibson, while the Dream and Bugsy have got Mantell and Lawler down, and Steve Keirn being held by the Nightmares. Oh, boy, they have got Rick Gibson really bleeding. His nose, blood's coming out of his mouth. They busted up his left eye in there. Tojo with that stick swinging away. McGraw put down by Mantell, and there goes the Dutchman in the ring to help the Gibsons out. Ricky, a mess. Bugs. Bugs and the Dream working on Lawler. Keirn caught in between the two nightmares. While the Dream and Bugsy work on Lawler, the nightmare is on Steve Keirn. Tojo's down with Mantell helping out. Rick Gibson a mess in the middle of the ring. Robert getting a hold of Fuchi. Oh, boy.
Got the war club now.
Yeah. Dutch has got that stick, and he's after Tojo. There goes the Japanese team. The Gibson's coming out after Onita. Dundee flying into the frame with McGraw and the Dream Machine. Hit him with a chair, nails one of the nightmares. Dream down. Boy, I'll tell you, it is impossible to have it all. Jerry, what's going to happen on the thing? With all of that, well, what a shambles.
Right
in the middle of the championship matches. I didn't really see where at all. Billy's complaining about. I was involved in this here.
Lawler was over here.
Yeah,
and they had
Hart was out here bagging him out of the ring, and Billy was up there. And
with both of the Japanese.
Yeah.
He got the pin. When the referee came back into the ring, Billy was pinned. He counted three, and that was it. So that's 9 minutes and 1 second of the match. The Japanese team won it.
Referee Jerry Calhoun was just like I was, trying to get Lawler and Hart out of here. And he jumped out of the ring in there, and the Japanese probably double-teamed Dundee. And the end result was he when he gets back in there, Dundee's down, they count one, two, three.
Exactly.
And he just verified that the AWA title has been transferred now to the team of Onita and Fuchi. We're going to take time out. We'll verify that ourselves in just a moment.
Another first round TV tournament match. This one also one fall, 15-minute time limit. Introducing a 212 pounds nightmare number one. And on the right of your screen, at 232 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, the King, Jerry Lawler. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Referee Jerry Calhoun.
With the second of the first round matches for the TV vacated TV title, Dave. Lawler's got to be a favorite, although I will say that nightmare number one, while giving away a little weight, brother, he is some kind of rough.
He is indeed. Well, he has been rough and tough against all opponents. He, along with his partner, nightmare number two. Oh! Back on the rope. And the referee is warning him about that. Jerry Lawler complaining about being shoved down, and the nightmare said, hey.
Hooked his leg and dumped him is what he did.
He said, we were on the rope and wanted to break. That's why he did it again. Hooked that leg back behind Lawler's left leg and just shoved him back to the mat.
Get him, get him, get him, get him. And let these idiots shut their mouth.
back onto the rope. Jumps the nightmare into the mat a couple of times. And again. Now the nightmare. He claims that Lawler pulled his mask. That's the way he was getting him off his feet.
Just a little turnabout being fair play right there, Dave.
Exactly what it amounts to. Center of the ring, Lawler fired into the rope. Both of them going. Nightmare set. Presses Lawler to the mat. Count of one, two. Lawler.
Really fired him up the air, didn't he?
Boy, he sure did. He broke that up at the count of two without any trouble whatsoever. Now the Nightmare wants conference with the referee. He's talking to the crowd. He said, you saw it, you saw it. And they're saying, what?
Who cares? He didn't know anything would pull my mask. That's the only thing he knows how to say. Because the Nightmare being one of the first family, I was just looking at Lawler, and of course this guy is nobody to take lightly, this Nightmare. Lawler really very intense in this bout. Oh, beauty. Put him down hard.
But Lawler is sustaining part of the damage there. Maybe he drove his nose into that mat as he put the brakes on.
A bulldog on him in there, and the Nightmare taking time out to do a little commentary on how great he is. He'll get his brains knocked out that way.
Trying to bulldog again. Lawler jumps him under the rope. Suplex. And the Nightmare rolling on the mat now. Lawler picks him up. The opportunity to get out of the ring. There he is, down on the floor. Now looking to the crowd for sympathy and finding none. There is Lawler. He's waiting on the Nightmare as he's bouncing around the outside of the ring. Now back up on the apron, through the rope. 3 minutes, 50 seconds. So we're coming up on the four-minute mark of this tournament match. First round action in the tournament to decide the new championship wrestling TV champion. Nightmare number one with the headlock on Lawler. Four and a half minutes gone. Nightmare. Oh, pounding on Lawler. Roof back in the corner. Nightmare with that right fist, warned by the referee. First neck breaker, Lawler out of that one. Out of one, he's able to kick out.
Kicked out, but he didn't throw him off as he did in that first time in there. So the Nightmare having a little effect on the King.
Upper arm, a cover by the Nightmare. Down to one again. Lawler nailed by Nightmare number one. And again. Lawler answering in kind. He backs the Nightmare under the rope, whips him across the ring, upper arm. Nightmare hits the mat. Lawler backs up, going with the smash. Nightmare was gone. Lawler in the air, body slam. Nightmare goes for the rope. Lawler rolled out of the way. 5 minutes, 45 seconds into the action. Oh, Lawler with the arm. Hitting nothing. There's a nightmare at move. Waller hooks it down. Ball package. One, two, three. The rest of the first family gets the ring. Entire first family holding Jerry Lawler. Here comes Dundee. He grabs Hart. He turns to Gibson. Dutch Mantell. And the first family now brawled except for the Dream Machine. Dream Machine still there. Dundee telling the King about the box that Jimmy Hart brought in here. With whatever's in there, Green bails out of the ring. Lawler out of there after him. Oh. It's molasses. And more feathers. The winner of the match, boy, with the confusion there, Lawler did win it. He got the three count, 6 minutes, 4 seconds, the official time, so Lawler will advance in the tournament. Yeah,
Mike Ford drew feathers on it. Yeah, that makes Gibson and Lawler, if we can get around all the mess that came. Eddie Marlin stopping that stuff, boy, he popped a fine and right. I don't care what anybody else thinks. He popped it rightly. He got the first family. He got Lawler and Dundee and everybody. And well, anyhow, listen. I want to tell you about a match that had a lot of intensity. And boy, I tell you, this feeling between the first family and a lot of the other guys is really growing. I think you will see some of it displayed in a bout that took place between the superstar and Steve Keirn going against the Nightmares with Vice President Golden Boy Chick Donovan at ringside down there. Watch what happened.
Tag, Nightmare number one. Golden Boy Chick Donovan horsing around over there as the Nightmare distracting the referee. Keirn out of the corner and now back into action. Dundee way up in the air on the backdrop, and the Nightmare covers him. Two, and Billy is out. Dundee making a run for the corner. Right through the legs of the Nightmare, tag on Steve Keirn. Boy, look at this Keirn go. Bill got over there, made a great tag. He needed it. Abdominal stretch and a beauty. Look at the way Keirn has that leg hook. That's going to be it. Well, wait a minute. Dundee in. Knocked the other Nightmare down. The referee runs him out. Nightmare number two. Head butts. Keirn from behind. Two, and Dundee pulls him up. Number one pops Keirn in. Couple of almost. Keirn almost had a great one on the abdominal stretch. Look at Keirn. Beautiful move. But the other nightmare breaks it up. And Keirn slips in. Sleeper hold. Trying to keep the other nightmare out of the way. And Donovan, as the referee's running Dundee out. Uh-oh. Donovan in the ring. Dundee and Keirn got the nightmares out, and they're ripping Donovan's clothes off. The referee stopped it, I believe. He's going to disqualify Keirn, who's got a temper that flares on him. You can see the cast on Donovan's leg. Here comes Bugsy McGraw with a crutch of Donovan. He nails Dundee and Keirn. And Bugsy McGraw working on Keirn and Dundee. Donovan slamming Keirn now that he's been hurt by McGraw. Here comes the Gibson. And out go McGraw and the Nightmares. They're kicking Donovan all over the place. Donovan caught in the ring and now he rolls out.
Tell you, it was wild and Willie. This is no surprise that Dutch Mantell certainly has no love lost for Tojo Yamamoto. No. They ended up in a bout. You got to take a look at the highlights of. Let's look at it.
The ladder after the stick. He pulls it loose, and Dutch has got it. Dutch has got the fighting stick. Dutch says, you want to try climbing up the pole and getting the bull whip? And Tojo's saying, whoa, whoa. Now, here he goes over there. Dutch letting him go. Oh, boy. He's bagging Tojo into this one. Yamamoto trying to skinny up that thing, but he's not having it. Uh-oh, Dutch getting ready to go for a home run. Oh, Yamamoto flails it again. Or rather, Dutch nailing Yamamoto. Masa Fuchi. The bell has been sounded. And Dutch, and there's Onita going after the bullwhip. He's got it while Dutch is working on Tojo. Now back after Fuchi. Onita with that whip. I don't know whether he knows how to. Nah, he didn't get a chance to use it. Fuchi, Onita, and now Yamamoto tell him to hold him down. 3 minutes and 49 seconds. The winner is Dutch Mantell. Yamamoto stabbing Dutch with the end of that stick. They've got shot Dutch's whip around his neck. Onita and Fuchi holding him. The end of the fighting stick has been shattered. Referee trying to get him apart. Yamamoto jamming away. Crowd hollering. Somebody must be coming to help Dutch. Here comes superstar Steve Keirn. Onita being held by Dundee and Keirn working on him. Tojo back up in the ladder and Dundee right in the face. Oh, he's mashing him. With a final shot from Steve Keirn. Send Yamamoto out on the floor.
It turned into Pier 6, but then there was no doubt when you had that bullwhip and fighting stick, man,
no
it
problem.
Was not going to be a scientific wrestling match for a fight. What a brawl. We've got more of it coming up here in just a moment. We're going to see Onita and Fuchi going against the Gibsons right after this.
Hiroshima, Masa Fuchi, their manager Tojo Yamamoto, and going against them from Pensacola, Florida, 454 pounds total weight, the Gibson brothers, Rick and Robert. This match one fall, 15-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun is the referee.
Okey-doke, Dave. We're about ready to do it in there as Robert Gibson will be starting, obviously. Rick outside, and on this side of the ring, the championship belt's handed out, as well as the flag of the rising sun going to be deposited over with Tojo along with the fighting stick. We're about ready for the action as the referee trying to get one of the Japanese representatives out of the ring. They are the Southern Tag Champs. Mr. Onita starts out against Robert Gibson.
Gibson leading to referee Jerry Calhoun as Fuchi was a long way from the corner where he was supposed to be with a hand on the turnbuckle. Onita backs Robert Gibson onto the ropes. Referee is there, calls for a break. Robert Gibson steps quickly out to the center of the ring. Headlock by Robert Gibson. Onita puts into the rope, shoulder butt by Robert coming off. Robert jumps over it. Oh, reverses. Onita tried to set himself, roll it down. But Robert reversed it on him, goes for the side headlock, and that's where Mr. Onita is at the moment. Fuchi steps in there, no tag. Robert Gibson, head searches on him, drops both of them to the mat. And Brother Rick from out on the apron adds a kick. As Mr. Onita was walking past the area over there. Onita back through the ropes now into the ring. Masa Fuchi steps up onto the apron. There is a tag, and here is Masa Fuchi. Minute and a half into the action. Robert Gibson back to the corner. Here comes Brother Rick. First official look at Rick in the match. He grabs Fuchi's left arm. Fancy footwork from Rick Gibson.
Boy, he's a guy that can do it too, Dave.
Masa Fuchi unhappy about something. He said something to the referee. Rick Gibson just yanked him off his feet down to the mat.
Yeah, there are arm drags and then there are arm drags. And man, he slammed him onto that mat with that one.
That's one of the better ones you'll see. Rick over to the corner, makes the tag. Here's Robert Gibson coming back in. Robert back down to the rope. Japanese wrestler fired him into the ropes, but Robert was set. He came off of there. Down to the mat goes Fuchi. And Robert Gibson with a bar on the arm.
Just a little side note, I noticed Onita started through the ropes, and immediately across the ring, Rick Gibson started. And he always has an eye. They have an eye on each other. That's why the Gibsons work so well together.
Robert Gibson puts Mr. Onita flat on his back in the center of the ring. He's got a headlock on him. Shoulders were not down in pin position, but Robert in control nonetheless. Oop, Japanese have Robert over in their corner. We are now at the three-minute mark. 3 minutes gone in this match. A little hair pulling, looks like, by Mr. Onita. Robert Gibson into the rope. Whoa! He knocked the Japanese down, but he was knocked through the ropes down onto the floor. Onita is down in the ring. There's Robert Gibson. He went through the rope. Boy, they hit hard. Robert bounced back, falling through the rope. Look out, Tojo with a fighting stick right across the back.
Rick had come flying over and kept Fuchi from jumping down on Robert. And as the referee is running off. Yamamoto, Dutch apparently saw on a monitor Yamamoto slamming away at him, and he came roaring out. Dutch is staying in their corner, by the way.
Yeah. Robert Gibson having his hair pulled, being worked on by both of the Japanese. Fuchi stays in the ring. Robert in the air. Ooh, power slam. Fuchi with a chop, jab, over to the corner. Tag on Onita. Onita up on the middle rope. Drops down with a chop across the forehead. Robert Gibson really being worked on by both of this Japanese team. We are at the five-minute mark. 5 minutes gone. Fuchi. Trying to get over to the tag on Brother Rick, could not make it. He grabbed and drop kicks him.
Japanese team working very close together now on Gibson.
They've got Robert away from his corner, trying to keep him away from the tag on Brother Rick. And they're double teaming him. Into the rope. Double chop by Fuchi. We are very close to the 6 minute mark. 6 minutes gone. Mr. Onita with a foot high in the air. Nailed Robert Gibson with it. Follows with a chop. Back on the rope. Fires Robert across the ring. Robert ducks under. Drop kicks and puts him on the mat. Onita, Fuchi, team to keep Robert from the tag on Rick Gibson. So Robert has to stay in there. Robert over to the corner. Here comes Rick. 6.5 minutes gone. And the action continues. Drop kick by Rick puts Fuchi on the mat. Reversal by Fuchi. Rick rolls it down. Tojo. Oh, he got him right in the head with that fight stick.
Yamamoto.
Mantell. Beating up Tojo Yamamoto over here by the table. Match match is over. Disqualification on Tojo when he nailed Rick with that stick. The referee was right there. That's Mantell. Put Fuchi down on the mat. He goes to work on him in the ring. Watch Tojo. Look out.
Tojo's got the handcuffs.
He's got those handcuffs that Dutch brought in.
Oh.
And had over here on the table. Using a fighting stick on the Gibson brothers while Tojo is handcuffing Dutch Mantell. He's got him handcuffed to the bottom rope. Now Tojo takes the fighting stick. Dundee was thrown out of the ring by Onita. He comes round again. Look out, Onita and Fuchi out of the ring. They grabbed the tag team belt. Here comes Tojo. Onita back to pick up the fighting stick.
Yamamoto picked them up, went in there, put him around Dutch's arm, put him to the rope, got that fighting stick, and just beat the stew out of Dutch with it. Boy, I am telling you what. Dutch Mantell, he nailed Dutch with those handcuffs right in the back of the head, right at the neck. Bill Dundee and Steve Keirn came in there, and they had their hands full before they finally got it going with the Gibsons, Keirn, and Dundee to get it under control. And all the time, Tojo was beating away on Mantell, and Dutch had been put into nighty-night land with those handcuffs when he hit him in the back of the neck with them. And handcuffed to the rope down there. They're trying to get the stretcher that was here at ringside out. Now they're helping Dutch out on. Boy, what a shellacking he took down. Never had a chance. He was in there trying to help out with the Gibsons on it, and he had Fuchi down, I believe it was, and Yamamoto had grabbed the handcuffs off the desk here, went flying back up there, and glommed him right in the back of the neck with it. And they're taking Dutch out on it. Dutch was just really in here to help the Gibsons out.
That's
too.
All, yeah.
Because when Tojo got involved and slammed Robert with that stick, Dutch got sick of that, came roaring in, and got after Tojo on it. He was standing in the corner trying to keep it right. Okay, well, the official winner, the Gibsons with
right.
The interference with Tojo with that stick from the outside, and we're going to take time out. We'll be back in a moment.
2:15 was the time. 2:15.
2:15. The official win is going to go to the team of McGraw and the Dream Machine. And, of course, again, as so often happens, an able assist with what? Look, Jimmy. I'll talk to you later on. I'll talk to you later on, Jimmy. We'll just get this down.
Come on, get out of here, man. Talk to me now.
Will you just take it on back there with McGraw and that?
And be sure and take your walking stick with you. Everybody saw you using the thing except the referee.
You're blind like everybody else. I didn't do anything because I don't have to do anything. Here, throw me my sunglasses out here. Thank you, my man. I appreciate that. You know, I've been making a lot of observations lately.
Oh, big deal.
No, I have. You know I have, man, because you know what? It's just like E.F. Hutton, baby. When Jimmy Hart talks, everybody listens. You understand that?
Yeah, I can see them all listening.
Well, you know, like I said, I've been doing a lot of thinking lately, making a lot of observations. And, you know, there's a man right here now that I think is world-class championship material.
Oh, I know. The first family's got, who is it, Bugsy or Dream Machine or one of the nightmares in there that you're so proud of?
No, Buzzard Breath, it's not. Let me tell you who it is, man. It's somebody that you can't even believe, but this man is definitely world championship material, and I hate to see him waste his life away with the people that he's hanging around. And the man's name is Steve Keirn. Steve Keirn is the... Yes, sir.
You're saying that?
I'm saying that I've been watching Steve Keirn now for about 5 or 6 weeks, and I'm telling you, the man has got championship material.
With the misery that he's inflicted on your first family, talking about Steve Keirn?
Well, let me just say
this. You got something up your sleeve.
We have something in common, Steve Keirn and Jimmy Hart, baby, and it is that I hate Orientals. And I know Steve Keirn hates Orientals because I know that he loves and respects his father very, very much, just like I love and respect my father very, very much. And I know also that Steve Kern's father was a prisoner of war in Vietnam.
That's
it
true.
Was in all the papers. You know it, and I know it, too.
No point in going
so like
into
I said
that.
Before, there is no love lost between Jimmy Hart and the Orientals, and I know how Steve Keirn feels about them. And so, to make a long story short, what I'm trying to say right now is this, is that... There's an opening position right now in the first family professional wrestling. And I'm telling you right now, Steve Keirn, if you're listening to me, that's right, laugh, Russell. Go ahead, laugh. Be a smart aleck and laugh. I'm saying right now, Steve Keirn, if you're listening in the back, there's a position waiting for you, baby, because I like your action. And with Jimmy Hart by your side, you can be a world champion. You can be everything that you're not now.
You're trying to invite Steve Keirn into the... You know what? I really think in that brain of yours that you are dead serious in there. But listen, you know what I really think is behind the whole thing?
Well, what's that?
And that is simply because Tojo Yamamoto has champions.
Oh, God.
Jimmy Hart doesn't have the Southern Test.
Let me tell
Who's got
you
him? You guys
baby.
Don't
Who
have
Who won the belts for him? If I hadn't have been out here, they wouldn't have won the belts because Lawler left Dundee, left
you're
in the ring,
you're afraid that
fool.
Yamamoto has outdone you
the
in the wrestling business,
listen,
and you're trying to figure
right.
some way
the
to
only
get a
thing,
guy to hurt them.
Well, baby, the only thing holding him up is his very close veins on Tojo Yamamoto. He's going to have a heart attack in the ring, and Jimmy Hart will be long here after he's dead and gone.
You can believe
that.
I think you're afraid.
I'm not scared of anything or anybody, and you know it. And get that smart grin off your face, because Gordon Sully's going to take your job over. How you like
yeah,
that, stupid
yeah,
jerk?
Fine. Well,
but I'm saying it right now.
You're worried about Tojo taking yours, though.
Well, what I'm saying is Steve Keirn right now, baby. That's what I'm saying. There's a position in the first family. You shut your big... That's a, oh, shut up. Take that baby out of here with you.
Get out of here.
I hate freeloaders. No, I'm
you
not going
to be
here.
Joking.
All right. Am I joking now? Am I serious now, brother?
Steve Keirn's his own man.
You
he does his own talking.
Own
Nobody
man,
tells
right.
him anything.
But it ain't no talent when I see talent.
Yeah, well, I know the kind of talent you're looking for. This guy says there's an opening in the first family. He's had his eye. He thinks you're championship material. And he, because the fact that he doesn't like Orientals and the unfortunate experience that your father had in there, he thinks you got a lot in common, Steve.
Well, first of all, Lance, Jimmy Hart's right about one thing. My dad was a prisoner of war in Vietnam for 7.5 years. Maybe that's what I attribute to not liking the Orientals. But you know something, Hart? You're promising me an awful lot by making me the world champion. And that's something that I've always wanted. Everybody knows that. But that's something that every professional should want. But you know, there's something else my dad taught me. He says that you've got to be able to trust a man before you can put yourself
Amen.
In his hands.
Amen. Not the most trustworthy soul I ever saw.
Well, let me just say something right now. I think this speaks for itself. I could have kicked Chick Donovan out in the cold, cripple a gimp, but who stood by him? Jimmy Hart. So I think that has to speak for something right there, baby.
Yeah. I don't know what. Always thinking.
I'm out here giving you a chance of a lifetime, Keirn. Look at you. You're with Dundee. Dundee has gone through 50 partners a year, man. He's washed up. You're not like him. You know that. You've got everything going. You have got youth. You have got charisma. And that's what the First Family lives on, baby. It's magic. And Jimmy Hart is magic, and Jimmy Hart can make you, brother. And that's the deal.
Watch it up the sleeve.
Well, you know, like I said, my dad taught me to be able to trust a man. Now, if I'm going to be able to trust a man, you know, you just got your leg out of a cast not too long ago.
Right.
It's probably still pretty weak.
That's right.
Probably could be injured real easily, right?
There's no doubt about it.
Well, I'll tell you what. In order for me to trust you, you're going to have to trust me. So I'm going to make you a deal. I'm going to get you in the ring. I'd like you to get up in the ring. And I'd like you to let me place you anywhere in the ring that I can place you. And then I'll climb up that top rope, and I'll let your leg lay right across that bottom rope. And you'll be looking up at me that whole time, and you'll be wondering, is there a slightest doubt in my mind? And if you'll let me get up there, I'll make either one or two decisions when I climb up there. I'll either come down, and I'll re-break your leg right here on television, or else... Now, there's another part of it. This is where your trust has to come into my hands. You're going to have to show me you trust me. You're going to have to say, I trust you, Steve, with all my heart. I'll come down that rope. I'll reach out. I'll shake your hand. And you'll make me the next world's heavyweight champion.
There you are, Jim. Just like a man, man to man, he's saying you got to trust me in order for me to trust you. Just climb right up there and let him make that decision.
You have got to be kidding. Are you serious? Hey, wait, hold it. Hold it. Come here.
You don't want to do
wait
it.
Wait a minute, Russell. Why don't you shut up and keep out of this? Will you shut your big fat mouth?
Well, you just about used up enough time. He made you a fair proposition.
Well, listen, I got all the time I want. Let me tell you something. So that's your deal, huh, Steve? Well, I'm going to let you know where my heart's at because, brother, I believe you are a champion, and I'll do it. I'll get in that ring, and I'll do it.
You're going to climb up and put your leg on
it. Because I promise you, I can turn this man into a world champion. You will be the greatest thing in the family. Bugsy McGraw, the Dream Machine, and all of my people, man. And I'm telling you, this is the final touch on it.
I'm not believing this. He's accepting the offer in there, Steve.
Man's got a lot of trust in me, doesn't he?
Well, I'll tell you what. I said, I thought he was dead serious. I'm not really...
I've been more serious than I've ever been in my life, Steve Keirn. I'm telling you right now.
Well, quit running your mouth and get up in the ring in there. There he is.
Don't wear this jacket either while I'm gone.
Jimmy Hart has agreed... As a matter of his indication of trust in Steve Keirn, to let Keirn climb up on the top rope, he has already made him one of two choices. He's either going to jump off on the leg, Dave, or he's going to come down, take it. And he's going to make himself part of the First Family at the hands of Hart. Hart... His leg's still tender. He just got it, what, 2 weeks ago,
two
I
weeks
think.
He got the cast off, yeah.
Just got it out of the cast. Keirn laying it up on the bottom rope. He's telling Jimmy, just lay back and take it easy, Jimmy. Steve Keirn. Now satisfied with his replacement, Hart saying, hey, come on now. Remember, you can climb down and become the world heavyweight champion. Steve goes up to the top rope. Decision time as Keirn stands up. Hart saying, hold it. Now, wait a minute. He didn't realize how high... Keirn was going to be up there, whether he flies or walks down those ropes. Keirn looks around at the people, and he came off on Hart's leg. Ooh.
the Dream Machine is Bugsy McGraw, the Nightmares, Chick Donovan. As he got it.
One thing I failed to mention, Lance Russell, that my dad also taught me another lesson. And Jimmy Hart, when you get where you can listen to this, you're going to learn something from this, brother. My dad taught me something else. He says no matter how good the offer is, never, never accept anything from your enemies.
Well, there you go. Maybe Hart, who thought he's too smart to learn anything from anybody, has just learned a lesson from Steve Keirn. As Keirn never said he wasn't going to come off on it. What he said was, you got a choice. I'll either come
down. What he said, all right?
Yeah, I know. Okay, Bugsy, just take your wounded hero out of here. As Steve said, I'll either come down and shake hands and it's a deal, or I'll jump down on your leg. He never said he wasn't going to jump down
on
his leg.
No, he didn't.
And there goes Jimmy Hart. The wounded leader is Steve once again pounded down. Boy, he really.
Davey, it's kind of an interesting new era with this great young team, and I would like to refresh a lot of people's memory about it. They came in here having won the Tri-State Tag Championship. They then were in line for a Southern Tag Championship. They went against Onita and Fuchi, and obviously had to be the underdogs in that match. Let's take a look.
Stretch, but Rick Morton with Onita, and here comes Yamamoto. Nails Gilbert with that fighting stick, while the referee still trying to get Morton out of there and Onita out. Fuchi, oh, what a chop from Onita on Morton.
Following that, right on our championship wrestling television program, we were happy and they were obviously delighted at having won the Southern Tag. But that was only an omen of things to come.
And Rick and I aren't going to sit around and pamper these belts or anything. We're going to be trying to defend them against the top contenders, and we're going to be wrestling champions, Lance. And we're not going to sit around and let these get dust on them or anything. We're going to be defending them just as soon as we can.
Well, in addition to that, when you defend them, that means a little bit more money, too.
That's it, because you got these belts, it means more money. It means getting better things for you, and that's what me and Rick are trying to do.
Well, now. I know that it's a real thrill for the wrestling fans and for everybody. It's particularly a thrill for Tommy because he had the... Okay, Tojo, now you got some interview time later on.
Look, I why don't you give us, give my team the chance to wrestle you folks? Why?
Hey, listen, Tojo, wait a minute. You just listen to me. You remember just like I do, when we sat down to write the contract out for this, at the top of the contract, the return match clause had been X'd out. And you X'd it out because you thought we were two punks and we couldn't beat you. But you got the two punks, and you're going to have to wait in line before you get a match for them.
Okay, Tojo. That's it. There's your answer.
I tell you what. I know your father a long time ago. Your father is coward, you understand?
Oh,
your father, your family, also your mother, you understand?
Hey, look.
Hey, coward!
You talk.
Hey, come on, Eddie. Eddie. Come on, Eddie. Get these. Hey, Eddie, come on now. There's place for that, and it's not right now. Give me a little help in here, son. Yeah. Eddie, come on now. Eddie. Hey, come on now. That's enough, Eddie. Hey, please, let's break it up. Come on now, Eddie. Thank you, yeah. All right, Eddie. Hey, come on. Get Eddie Gilbert.
Later in the same championship wrestling TV program, Eddie Gilbert and Rick Morton were involved in a match in there, but there came some other involvement. Let's take a look at what happened.
Okay, come on. Onita and Fuchi. Joined by Yamamoto, taking some revenge on Gilbert. More Tojo just keeps blistering. Eddie Gilbert with that fighting stick. Referee Jerry Calhoun trying to get order restored. Rick Morton continuing to try to get in there and help his. Oh, Eddie is holding.
That was the Japanese opportunity at that time. That was not the whole story, though, because as you remember, Dave, later in the program, Onita and Fuchi were in the ring wrestling.
Keeping Onita back.
Tojo!
Tojo in the ring. Oh, salt or some other kind of... the eyes, the Dutch Mantell, disqualification on the Japanese team. Look out, Mantell. Pile driver put on by Masa Fuchi.
Tojo with that fighting stick wailing on Mantell. And of course, you know the kind of feeling between Yamamoto and Mantell as Onita and Fuchi are Steve Keirn around. You saw Onita off with a big chop on Keirn while Fuchi held him. And Tojo just pounded away with that stick. Disqualification. Dutch had a good abdominal stretch and the referee disqualified it when Tojo jumped in. Yamamoto, I guess he figured. Here they come. Hey, Gilbert, Rick Morton.
Believe it or not, that was only the beginning. We've got more of the story coming up in just a moment. The first opportunity of following all the action here on Championship Wrestling with Eddie Gilbert and Rick Morton to meet in the ring officially Onita and Fuchi took place in Tupelo, Mississippi.
Right.
Need I say more? Take a look.
Goes at the chin with that one. Makes the tag on Eddie Gilbert. Comes Eddie. Look at that. Onita, then Fuchi, and right back to Onita and Fuchi again. Eddie Gilbert, much the fresher of the two, a whip into the ropes. There's that slide, takes him down. Could be the third fall, but Martin and Onita, here comes Yamamoto. Right in the eyes of Eddie Gilbert while the referee is over trying to get Onita and Morton apart. One, two, three. The fall is going to go to Masa Fuchi and Mr. Onita. Oh, yeah, the crowd didn't like it either. Fuchi in a position to be pinned, but Onita and Morton battling away, the referee trying to get them out of the ring. Tojo slipped in, fired the salt, I presume, into Gilbert's eyes. Morton takes away the fighting stick, hammered away on Tojo Yamamoto. Going after Onita and Fuchi, and now they're after Morton again. With that fighting stick. Boy, they may have lost the official match on that third fall, but I can tell you one thing, Morton is knocking some home runs with that Japanese fighting stick as he wails Fuchi with it. Eddie Gilbert down on the floor. Gilbert and Morton, Fuchi and Onita, Yamamoto. Concession stand. Get back up here. Get up here where you're not going to get hit. Into the concession stand after tearing down the partition. Our mic cable's caught. If you have to, Randy, just go around me. I can't get it loose from the chair. That's okay. Rick Martin slams Yamamoto. Glass, everything all over the floor in the concession stand. As Fuchi, nailed down by Eddie Gilbert, picks up the bucket of ice, slams Yamamoto with it. Gilbert. Oh, Nita's head busted wide open. Rick Martin slams a mustard jar on Yamamoto, and he's yellow everywhere. Blast Onita. Here comes Fuchi. Look out. Save what you can save there. Eddie Gilbert bleeding. Tojo Yamamoto covered with blood. Onita. Watch out, Randy. Well, I can't get loose. Go around me if you have to. Morton going after Onita, who is bleeding. Yamamoto with mustard and blood all over him. Eddie Gilbert pounded by Fuchi. Fuchi's ears bleeding. Rick Martin picks up a board, slammed Tojo right to his knees. He's now got Onita into the ice machine. Marlin trying to get him separated down here as Gilbert slipping in the mustard slams Onita, totally covered there by that big fan over here. Gilbert busting up Yamamoto as Fuchi nails Eddie Gilbert. They're sliding all over the mustard on the floor. Referee Paul Martin can't keep his footing. Gilbert slammed by Fuchi. Eddie with a board, and Fuchi nailed him again, but Gilbert and that board making good use of it. Eddie Marlin trying to get him broken up. Marlin got hit in the arm. Yeah, look out, Randy. With a trash can. Nails Onita. They have destroyed this concession stand. Rick Martin with a garbage can top by Yamamoto. Eddie Gilbert, Fuchi right below it. Fuchi's ear bleeding terribly. Gilbert's bleeding from both eyes. You see the scene in this Tupelo concession stand. They've already torn down the partition. Marlon gets Gilbert and Martin out of there. Herman takes them down to the floor. Eddie Marlon got Martin and Gilbert out of here. Here comes Marlon back in. Marlon grabbing at Yamamoto, who is wild, swinging at anything that moves. Yamamoto out. Martin hit him with a trash can flush. Eddie Marlon having no success in breaking him up. They're just totally out of hand. Eddie trying to get the stick away from Onita. We're not going to be able to show a lot of it, but just keep shooting it. Almost out on their feet. As Fuchi was getting ready to nail Gilbert, Morton caught him with that broomstick. Eddie Marlon had at least half of it stopped. Gilbert and Morton, Yamamoto jumped Herman. Gilbert later came back in. I don't know. May have to get some more people in, yeah. They've destroyed the concession stand. They tore down the partitions at the restroom. Fuchi still got that broomstick, and he is really pounding Eddie Gilbert. I don't know how there are any of them standing up. I've never seen such punishment and beating on both sides of it. Gilbert swinging that stick again on Fuchi. Well, Onita, face first, down on the floor. Move them out again. They can just get part of them out again. Grabbing anything they can put their hands on. Onita pulling himself over the counter. Marlon trying to get Fuchi out of there. There goes Fuchi. Yeah, go on, just keep shooting it. We'll see what we can use on it. Fuchi and Gilbert over the counter. Onita, there comes Martin, but back over. over by the dressing rooms. They're still fighting. Yamamoto grabs a board. He's going after him, but I think they got him safely in the dressing room.
Boy, I'll tell you. Just unabridged brawl. That's all there was to it.
The entire week of action around championship wrestling, one of them in Jerry Lawler's own hometown was a match with the Dream Machine that stunned the wrestling world. Let's take a look. Coco trying to get the Dream to let up with him as he slams his head to the turnbuckle. And Lawler resists. What they've been waiting for. Lawler, big right hand, and another. The 15-minute mark, Lawler goes up to the rope. Flies off there with that fist. One. Here comes Chick Donovan. Swinging the cane. Remember, no disqualification. Lawler gets up, nails Donovan. And the Dream coming after Lawler hits Donovan. Wrestlers down. Donovan trying to get the Dream up. And as Lawler gets up, the Dream nails him. One, two, three, and stunned. Jerry the King Lawler has been defeated.
Hard to believe, I'll tell you for a fact in there. And we were sitting right at ringside, heard a lot of accusations about how it happened. But it was difficult to really verify any of the accusations except one thing, no disqualification match. And the Dream was the one that came out the winner. We're going to take time out and we'll be back in just a moment.
And they're ended right now.
Glory, 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 the king.
Yeah,
you got something to say about it, huh?
I got nothing to say about it. I want to know what the purpose for all this is.
The purpose is today that I am honoring one of the most outstanding men in our sport today. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to present to you right now, King Jimmy Hart.
Disappointed in you, Coco.
Hallelujah.
I can tell you that.
Hallelujah. I love you, man. I love you.
You look great.
Watch my grandma.
You look
great,
Jimmy,
just like the king
that
you are.
The king is here. Listen to the people. Help. They know I'm the king of professional wrestling.
Hail the king. Hail the king. Hail the king.
Okay, okay.
Your Majesty, hail the king.
Thank you.
Just
turn it down just a little bit,
yeah,
Russell.
Fine, great.
Look at him, people, the king of professional wrestling. Listen at him, listen at him. You know, Lance, let me tell you something right now. Somebody this past week just became a man. Yes, a man in professional wrestling. A man that was kicked out by the people that was supposed to love him.
Right on.
A man that's been abused
Hallelujah.
And misused for a long time. And I want to bring him up right now. Come here, come here. Come here, come here. Somebody hold this. Hold this down. Come here, man. Come here. I want to show the world something to you right now, brother. Look at this man right here. Coco Ware, let me tell you something, darling. I want to tell you something. Last week, you became a man in professional wrestling. Now, I know a lot of you ignorant people out there are saying, yeah, look at Jimmy Hart. He's going to probably put him in the family to have a little color to the family. Well, you are wrong. I love this man, baby. Let me tell you something, brother. If you want to be in the first family, you are here to stay and not to play, because when we're on top and we're going to rock. I want to do something for you. I want to give you the chance of a lifetime, a chance of Dundee and Keirn and all those other little punks wouldn't do for you, man. A lot of talk, but I don't see no action. Do you want to be in the first family of professional wrestling?
Right, I want to be in the
first.
Well,
brother, you are in it, and I'm fixing to crown this man right now. Come here, baby. I want to crown this man right now. Not Coco Ware, because that name is out of date, baby, but I want to crown you sweet, brown, Sugar, the newest member of the professional wrestling.
All right, baby.
The food, baby. I'm hungry. Oh, wait, we're not through. We are not through yet. We're not through.
Jimmy,
we're not through, baby.
Well, get on with it.
And now, only what could be held for a king, baby, is a meal for a king, if you understand what I'm saying. And now, would you bring in, please, Sylvester Bondelet.
I am not believing it. I should believe it. I should believe it for this crew I got right. That is not Sylvester. No. My boy Sylvester.
You will scoop to
any end. Thank you, darling. I appreciate that. Thank you. You know what? I love this. Right now. Into the mouth. Over the gums. Look out, stomach. Here Sylvester comes. Come on, baby. Bring it over here.
Let's go to a break. Get out of here. No, I don't want it. Take a break. Take a break. Will you guys just...
You check my nerves and you rattle my brain. You must love drive a man sane. Broke my wheel. What a thrill. Got an issue raised. Balls of fire. I let the love of the thought of the money. There came along and you moved me, honey. Came my mind. Love is mine. Give it to me, quick, all the time. Kiss me, baby. Woo, feel good. Oh, mama. Yeah, that old killer love you like a lover should. You're fine, so kind. I'm gonna tell this world that you're mine, 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 mine. You're my girl. Thank you.
Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go.
I tell you, a lot of people felt the wrath of that big right hand of Jerry the King Lawler. I want to just say right here a special word of thanks to Randy West, our championship wrestling video man. You have no idea the number of hours and that you spend looking through tapes and fitting it together and putting it to the music and all. Randy, I think, does a super, super job, and you never get to see him. But he just does a great job week after week of giving us some super stuff, too, and we appreciate that from Randy. Listen, it takes two to tango, a Southern heavyweight champion named the Dream Machine. Got some interesting footage we'd like to show you here.
There's a man in the funny papers we all know. He lived way back a long time ago. Don't eat nothing but a bear cat stew. Well, this cat's name is Alley-Oo. He got a chauffeur that's a genuine dinosaur. And he can knuckle your head before you count to four. Got a big ugly club and a head full of howl. Like great big lions and grizzly bears. He's the toughest man that is alive. Wearing clothes from a wildcat's hide. He's the king of the jungle jazz.
Look at that caveman door.
Jungle tearing limbs off of trees, knocking great big monsters dead on their knees. The cats don't bug him cause they know better. Cause he's a mean motor scooter and a bad go-getter. Toughest man there is alive. Wears clothes from a wildcat's hide. He's the king of the jungle jive.
Look at that caveman go.
There he goes. Look at that caveman go. He sure is hip, ain't he? Like what's happening? He's
well, there he is, Alley-Oop Dream Machine. He had his ups and downs, as you well saw there. And sometimes was like that comic book character, the Dream Machine, who is the current Southern heavyweight champ, as a matter of fact. And Jimmy Hart.
What's wrong with you, man? What the hell's the matter with you?
Jimmy Hart, the Dream Machine, he's fired. $1,000 right here. You'll pay it or you won't wrestle here today or tomorrow, no other time.
Okay, Eddie, okay.
Okay.
I'm not paying you nothing.
Get him out of here, Hart.
Just take him out. I'm not paying you nothing.
Okay,
okay.
I'm not paying you nothing.
Get out of here. We'll be back.
Before we start, I just...
just want to get it. Everybody just saw it right there. It just cost you $1,000, which you guys had to pay. Now, if you want to try for another $1,000, just keep right on.
Don't touch him.
You throw the slurs, but we try for another $1,000. You like to let your mouth overload your butt, Lance Russell. So I'm going to tell you that right to your face. Well, I might. Well, I've been to jail before. That's nothing new. Lawler, I'm going to tell you something right there. It's going to take place in Evansville, Indiana, Wednesday night. I will whoop you because you know it's no fear in my heart whatsoever that you can whoop my butt, boy, because you did everything under the sun to me, everything that you could possibly do to a human being that's still walking on the face of God's green earth. You burnt me. You took my mask off. You beat me. You did everything it possibly could, tarred and feathered me and left me out for the dogs, but you won't do it right there in Evansville, Indiana, because I've been beat there before, but I've never been beat in Evansville, Indiana by you, and I will never be beat there. Jimmy Hart, I promise you, with everything I have in my body and my heart and my soul and in my pocketbook, this belt would not leave me. You understand what I'm saying? Because this belt, the only time it'll ever leave my person is when I bathe, and that's very seldom. Do you understand what I'm saying, Jerry Lawler? And Lance Russell, I'm sick and tired of you. You're in on it. I know you're in on it. Alley-oop. I got you, alley-oop. Yeah, I'm sick of you. I'm sick of Lawler.
Don't touch
him.
Don't touch
him.
You wait a minute. You will be tarred and feathered. Lawler, you will be the one tarred and feathered, baby, because that song matches you.
Lawler, you will be tired and feathered in Evansville, Indiana, Wednesday night, come rain, heat, hell, or snow.
Okay, you're not going to be messing with a 170-pound commentator. You just be there Wednesday night and see somebody. Okay, Wednesday. All right, now don't start that stuff. We'll see you out there Wednesday night. Rarely does it ever happen. Occasionally you'll see a jersey retired of a baseball player, a football player, or something, but this is an unprecedented situation to where an alliance has paid such recognition to an individual that they have retired a belt, and that is a situation that has occurred. Because of the accomplishments of the individual that we're going to ask that they bring out here, a permanent placement is going to be made of a Southern heavyweight belt. Will somebody get Jerry Lawler in here, please? Ask Jerry to come in here. Get Lawler out there. Over the 1970s in which this recognition has taken place, Jerry the King Lawler held the AWA Southern Heavyweight title in one of the most competitive areas ever, 6 of the 10 years that the existence during the 1970s. And because of this, the AWA, in special recognition of an incredible accomplishment, is now a presentation to be made by promoter Eddie Marlin. Eddie?
Jerry Lawler, on behalf of the directors of AWA, you've held this belt 6 out of the last 10 years. We want to present this to you as your personal property. I want to tell you that we're proud of you, and what more can be said?
Well, I can say this, that Jerry, it has been an incredible career. I've seen a lot of firsts for you, but I think you know that this is unprecedented in the annals of an alliance to retire a belt and give it individually. I'm proud of you, babe, and I got to give you a lot of congratulations.
Thank you, Lynn.
Okay.
Let me just say that, you know, I've had a lot of awards, and I've won a lot of titles, and had a lot of good things happen to me in the years that I've been a wrestler, but this is this by far tops it all.
So you've got to see some of the great highlights.
I did what I had to do.
started toward each campfire along the byway. Oh, and more, much more than this, I didn't mind the way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off
TV tournament match coming up, waiting for the opponent for Dutch Mantell. You see Dutch walking around the ring, waiting for him there.
Yeah, he's scheduled to go against Masa Fuchi out of Hiroshima, Japan.
My boys all messed up. The airlines messed up.
Wait a minute. What?
I think the airlines messed up with my boys. My boys all messed up with the airlines.
You
I don't know where they
are.
But I tell you what,
having
I,
a forfeit.
No. I challenge. I like to challenge him.
Are you want to challenge me? Hey, that's fine with me. Bring him back.
Dutch Mantell says, great as far as he's concerned. Well, they're both in the tournament. As a matter of fact, Tojo won just a little bit earlier. Started off with salt.
Bruce salt in his eyes right there before they had a chance to get in the ring, actually, before he got in the ring. Dutch Mantell against Tojo Yamamoto, tournament match. Tojo won his match earlier. Tojo with a chop. Dutch Mantell back in the turnbuckle. Dutch scheduled to go against Masa Fuchi, one of Tojo's Japanese tag team members. Tojo says that they are not here. That somehow the airline schedule got messed up and they need some stuff in there instead. Dutch Mantell finally got his shirt off and boy, he takes after Tojo. Tojo whipped into the rope. Dutch with a foot to the midsection and Dutch jumping up and down on Tojo. We're a minute into the action. Onita and Fuchi. Tojo disqualified.
Yeah, and there's his mysterious boys who weren't there.
Yeah. Airline problems, huh? Masa Fuchi, Onita holding up Dutch, and Masa Fuchi hitting him with a fighting stick. Tojo with instructions. You know, he's telling Fuchi on the ropes. With the stick, they're holding Mantell. Here's Billy Dundee. nailed Fuchi as he was coming off the rope. Now Dutchman's got the stick. Dutchman headed after Tojo. Dundee and Onita. Onita trying to get out of the ring. Fuchi trying to help him. Dundee nails Fuchi. Now the Japanese. Here's the end. 5 seconds, disqualification, and your winner is going to be Dutch Mantell.